Chinese-Filipino Literature. It refers to the Chinese people living in our country. It's equated with the writings in Chinese, Filipino, English, and other languages.
By Filipino, Chinese, this
bring the contact between the Chinese and the Filipino. Traders from southern China exchanged their fabrics, porcelain, ware, metal products, and many other goods. There is also an exchange of our culture between the Chinese and the Filipinos. And because of the Chinese, we have the so-called folk tales, myths, or old saying. There are a lot of books about the Philippines, and it was circulated in China as early as the 10th century, mostly about travel books. They describe the lifestyle of the early Filipinos and their business procedures. Because of the positive impressions of our country, it attracted many Chinese to the Philippines. A significant contribution of the Chinese was the printing of the three Chinese books.
Chinese literature was stopped during the invasion of the Japanese.
In my opinion, I couldn't say that it was stopped, it was more likely killed. But luckily, after the World War II, it was revived.
So to sum it all up, Chinese Filipino, or Chinese who are residing in our country, wrote books about loneliness, experiences from the past, history, love and companionship, anti-violence, violence. They even wrote screenplays, poetry.
After my introduction, there will be six reporters
who will be reporting on three topics. And these topics consist of three
Caroline Hall is an associate professor at the Center of Southeast Asian Studies in the University of Kent and author of various fiction and non-fiction books.
She took a Bachelor of Arts in English from the University of the Philippines and graduated summa cum laude in April 1990 and finished her postgraduate and PhD degrees in English Language and Literature at Cornell University.
Caroline Howe worked as an instructor at the Department of English in Cornell University. Her publications are about Philippine literature, among which are the following books: the Philippine Literature and the Nation, the Filipino Writing from 1981 to 2004, the New Year's Day, the Guardian of the Tears, the Girl in the Bathroom, Stories, Philippine Free Press, Grief, the True Story of Ato, Fire Trees, and Oryx and Bliss. A Very Short Story, Dictionary of Literary Terms, and the
Chosen Paco is a great Chinese-Filipino writer who won numerous awards at Memorial to Don Carlos Panaca Memorial Award in Literature. He was the recipient of the Philippine Imperial Literary Award in 1998. He received the Dr. Jose P. Rizal for Excellence in 2003 and the National Gawad Balantas in 2007.
Chosen was born on July 6, 1960 and graduated AB Psychology in the University of the Philippines in 1977.
Rosales has published a collection of short stories, Men of the East, Woman of Amcal, and Conversion.
He also published three novels, which are Embarrassment of the Riches, which won the Philippine Centennial Literary Prize, The Banyaga, A Song of War, which won the 2006 National Book Award, and lastly is The Blue Angel, White Shadow, which won the 2011 National Book Award.
Ato was a coolie, a baker, a shopkeeper's assistant, a taho vendor, a vegetable hawker, a guerrilla, and a communist fugitive. The speaker's grandfather had known Ato for a very long time. He died in his early 50s, and for the first 25 years of his marriage, he was living away from his wife, who remained in China. During Ato's early years, the speaker wished to have known Ato, but there was a war that men would go back again and again. It was a very bloody war. Ato was one of the few who made their way to China to begin another chapter, striving for a living.
It's hemorrhoids that got Ato. Hemorrhoids gave Ato a lot of memories. He can't really say his own memories or dictate his own memories clearly. But a year behind, he remembered that a video that was shown on the TV, where a huge crowd were mourning a person who was in the coffin who died on his own clothes and wasn't able to change. She thought that that kind of memory would move him from the pain that he was suffering, the pain of samurai. Second homecoming to China, he was able to visit Qing Kang.
Like all tourists, Ato had to leave Qing Kang at the end of 2 weeks. He felt like he outstayed his welcome. Well, he felt that way, but after all, he had got what he came for. Somehow, everything. Ato actually was confused whether he is from China or he is from the Philippines. So he was questioning his own self, whether is he a Chinese or a Filipino. Well, by the end of the story, I can still remember that Ato really never find out about him. But as long as he was still in the Philippines, he felt like it was home. Well, I know that you might be thinking, why am I wearing barong? And yes, reporters, they are wearing Chinese. So, in line with our topic, we would like to show respect to this culture because it has impact. It gave a lot of impact on us.
Chinese-Filipino literature is written by Filipinos of Chinese descent, natural-born citizens in the nation who learned the first language, which is either Filipino or Arabic. According to Charles Long, he considered Chinese-Filipino literature is a new literature, so meaning it is like a flower just bloomed.
We all know about the history of the Chinese here in the Philippines.
They had come as traders, which is known as market trade. And somehow, they write their experiences in the country in which was published.
My own impression that these writers were writing as overseas Chinese in the Philippines are Hua Xiao. Most of the writers nominally Chinese nationalists residing in the Philippines. Chinese people in the country needs to be naturalized. And many died not becoming a citizen even though they were born in the Philippines. The most important event for the Chinese people is when former President Marcos moved the naturalization of the Chinese in 1974. In the face of the Philippines' impending recognition of People's Republic of China instead of the government in Taipei.
Chinese schools before followed two curriculums which are based on the Philippines, which is the Department of Education and Kuomintang system. If we consider the Chinese literature to be created by third generation Chinese Filipinos, it is clearly that this literature has very little traditions. They're more inclined to read in English and Filipino rather than to speak in Chinese. Cultural recovery is growing concern in Chinese Filipinos. They are more comfortable with their dual heritage. Chinese Filipino writer isn't just focusing in recovery but also in reconstructing especially their lost traditions. Chinese Filipino referred themselves as Hua Ye versus Chinese as Hua Xiao, or in other words, Chinese bridges. To them, this bridge is somehow a decision of puzzlement because they wonder which is which.
Arquan Laurel is a doctoral student in the Department of English and Comparative Literature, College of Arts and Letters in the University of the Philippines.
When Laurel was growing up, everyone insisted that he and his family were Chinese, whether or not they had a say about it. Said that he still come from a generation that experienced racism in a very real way when many young Chinese Filipinos were ashamed of being known as Chinese to their non-Chinese friends.
In Ama, the tender romance that recalls the luminosity of Sarah Polley's prison film Away From Her. The story is not just about romantic love and a community, but very conscious about appearances. It is also about the secondary role of women in society. These conventions confront the unconventional love of two strong-willed fair citizens amidst issues of colonialism and colonial mentality. There's a clash of values on many levels.
That experience and many others orbiting Ongkin Street in Binondo, Manila has shaped his imagination and inhabit the first pages of Laurel's first book, Ongkin Stories, including the story Ama, published by the Kaisa Sokonlaran Incorporated. Though it represents his debut tome, Ongkin Stories essentially took a lifetime to put together.